Hi, it's Coach Aaron with Athletic Power and Performance. Now, you as an athlete, you're going to be challenged at different times. You're going to have different nicks and full-blown injuries. So with this video, I want to talk about the different types of therapies, not all of them, but specifically two types, which is your passive therapies and your active therapies. And what I mean by that is passive therapies are therapies that you have done to you. That's such as chiropractic, massage, and things like that. Active therapies are where you're actually engaged in the therapy, such as corrective exercise. Now, my point in this video is not to say, well, one is bad and you don't use that, you use the other one. It's knowing what you need at the time and knowing when you need one versus the other. So for instance, there's gonna be times where you will absolutely need passive therapies, such as your back is completely out of alignment and you need a chiropractor to go in and adjust it. But the reason why your back got out of alignment could be because you got injured, it could be because your posture has been off for so long and the chiropractor went in there and adjusted it. Whatever the reason, you need to understand the reason, and whether it is because you had a dysfunctional body mechanics or if the injury caused dysfunctional body mechanics, you need active therapy to fully correct the issue. Because if you're not fully engaged yourself into the therapy, when you get adjusted or you get massaged or whatever the passive therapy, and you go back into your sport and you start doing the movement, well, you have a certain body mechanics that you use, and if it's dysfunctional, you're gonna go right back into more dysfunction and have to have some sort of therapy later on. So understand that you will need oftentimes some passive therapy and some active therapy.